What is sampling? Actually, taking some samples from the continuous time signal. So if this is a continuous time signal, okay, we take some samples. So what samples we take? Few samples. These samples, these few samples represent the entire signal. Okay. Now we will call sampling rate FS. Okay, that should be greater than or equal to twice the IS frequency component. Correct? Now, so we have seen how to reconstruct. How to reconstruct? Pass this sample signal through a low pass filter. Now, this is called reconstruction. But it is possible if and only if, what is the condition? Your sampling rate must be greater than or equal to twice the highest frequency component of message signal. Okay. Suppose reverse happens. If FS is less than 2 FM, it is called aliasing effect. What is aliasing? What is aliasing? Overlapping of the copies of the original spectrum. The copies of the spectrum will overlap. So I explained everything in the last class. So I have shared the video. You just go through it. Anyway, you might be knowing the sampling things already. Okay. Now, so here we'll start ADC. ADC means analog to digital conversion. Okay. Obviously, ADC contains three blocks. What is that? Sampler. First thing is we do sampling. Okay, first we take analog signal. Okay, so analog signal is continuous in time and continuous in amplitude. Okay, suppose what analog signal, which is having continuous range of values of both time and amplitude, this is analog signal. Okay, why? Because here the time axis is having continuous range of values, as well as this amplitude axis is also having continuous range of values. Okay, it is continuous time, continuous amplitude signal. We sample it. If we sample, generally what happens? If we sample a signal, we denote like this sampling, we denote like this. If we sample a signal, what do you get? You get samples, which are what kind of signals? Generally, what happened now here? If you sample a signal, this is amplitude is continuous, but time is discrete, because time cannot take all continuous range of values. It is taking only a discrete set of values. Okay, if sample a signal, time will be discretized. So amplitude is still continuous, but time is discrete. Okay. Next, we perform something called quantization. It is called quantizer. Okay. We'll discuss what is quantizer. If you quantize, what will happen? So time is anyway discrete, but if you quantize, what happens? Amplitude is also getting discretized. Okay. Now later we do encoding. This is what encoding. You know what is encoding means. Okay, so if you do encoding, finally you get a digital signal. What is this signal? Digital. This is a digital signal. What input signal? Analog signal. What output signal? Digital signal. It is converting analog to digital. That's why it is called as ADC. You know all these things already. Okay, ADC, the major blocks are sampler, quantizer, encoder. You know already how to sample a signal. So let us discuss how to quantize and how to encode. Encoding is anyway very, very easy. Okay. So primarily we should discuss about this quantizer. What is a quantizer? Here you must know these things. If you sample a signal, time is discretized. If you quantize a signal, amplitude will be discretized. Okay. So this is way, this is how we do sampling and quantizing and encoding. Finally, you get a digital signal. What is a digital signal? It is a sequence of ones and zeros. Suppose you write these things, right? 100110. What is this? A digital data. Or simply call it as a data. Okay. What is this? It is a sequence of ones and zeros. Sequence of ones and zeros. Or sometimes it could be zero can be written as minus one also. Okay. Anyway, so basically it is sequence of ones and zeros. That is a digital signal. So to get analog to digital, we have to perform basically two operations: sampling and quantization. Encoding is to get the ones and zeros. Okay, right. Discuss. Okay, quantization. So this is a continuous time signal, the discrete time signal. You know already how to represent continuous time and discrete time. If I write x of t, it is a continuous time signal. If I write x bracket n, square bracket n, it is a discrete time signal. If you quantize, if you sample a signal, it becomes continuous time to discrete time. That is the basic idea of quantization. Okay, we write something general, we write like this: x of t, if you sample with the ts period, you get x of n. You get x of n. What is x of n actually? How would you define x of n? X of t defined at t equal to n times ts. Okay. Now, anyway, so let us proceed to the quantization. So, what is the quantization? Rounding of the sampled value to the nearest quantization level is called quantization. Okay. So, what is input to the quantizer? Yeah, what input to the quantizer? Sampled values. Which means, so first we take a signal, okay, we take a signal, actually suppose this is a signal, okay, we sample it, we get a this portion. Now this is applied to the sampled signal is given to the quantizer, is given to the what? Quantizer. So input to the quantizer is sampled signal. Correct? Now, so xq is the output of the quantizer. So generally what you say is, so to the quantizer, this is a quantizer, input is x, output is xq. What is x? It is a sampled value. It is also sampled value. What is xq? Quantized value. This is a quantizer. Q is a quantization function or quantizer. Sample value. Okay, so every quantizer has got some levels, L. Levels of quantizer. Every quantizer has got some level, discrete levels. Okay, we'll discuss how to get those levels. Okay, now we'll discuss uniform quantizer. Okay, basically there are so many types of quantizers. I mean, basically two types of quantizer. Let us start with the basic version, that is uniform quantizer. So why it is called uniform? Because the quantization levels are uniformly spaced. I will come to that later. Just remember this. Okay, now let us take some other parameters of this quantizer. Every quantizer has got some limits: x maximum, x minimum. Their limits of quantizer. Okay. So generally, don't think that people think that their limits of x of t. x of t is what? What is x of t actually? X of t or m of t? Yeah, this x of t. No, x maximum, x minimum are not the limits of or maximum minimum values of x of t. They are limits of what? Quantizer. Please remember this. There is a very big difference actually. Okay. So x maximum, x minimum are not the maximum and minimum value of x of t analog signal. In fact, they are limits of quantizer. I could have used a different notation, but it's okay. Okay, okay. So one more thing is here we are using a encoder. No, what is encoder? N-bit encoder. N-bit encoder. Okay. So actually, the number of levels depends upon the levels equal to 2n. How many levels you get? It depends upon n value. What is n? It whether it is a 2-bit encoder, a 3-bit encoder, a 4-bit encoder. Suppose if it is a 3-bit encoder, n equal to 3. How many levels you get? L equal to 2^3, that equal to 8. If you use 2-bit encoder, you get 4 levels. If you use 4-bit encoder, you get 16 levels. Okay. Right. So the number of quantization levels L equal to 2^n. Okay. Now, so one more thing is we have something called step size. Step size of the quantizer. I am not writing quantizer completely, just I write Q. That is denoted with delta. Okay. What is delta? It is x maximum minus x minimum by number of levels. X maximum minus x minimum by number of levels. So yeah, L equal to 2^n. You can also write here in place of L, you can also write 2^n. Anyway, this is the basic idea, basic formula. You must know this. Suppose if the quantizer its quantizer limits are symmetric. Symmetric means x maximum equal to minus of x minimum. Usually this happens, correct? Generally, so if you take any signal also, usually this happens, no? Suppose if I take the signal, this is 2, this is would be minus 2, correct? So what is the maximum value of the signal? 2. Minimum, minus 2. Okay. So, but remember, x maximum, x minimum are not necessarily the maximum minimum values of this x of t. I'm just taking for example. Okay. Suppose x maximum equal to minus x minimum. What about delta? The step size of the quantizer equal to 2x maximum or x minimum, both you can write by L. This is the final formula. If this is a formula, if and only if, please remember, this is true. In the same way, here you can replace with L with 2^n if you want, but you keep L as it is actually. Now, here, so there is something called quantization error. As I told you, what is error? It is output minus input, right? Generally, the error would be output minus input or input minus output. In this case, both are okay. So what happens here is, suppose if you take the quantizer, I told you input to the quantizer is sampled value or sampled signal, output is a quantized value. Okay. Now the error is x minus x cube. X minus x cube. What is x? Sampled value. X cube is a quantized value. So error is called as q. What is q means? Quantization error, that is defined as x minus xq. So you can also write reverse also, no problem. It is just the difference between input and output. Yeah, for uniform quantizer, the delta is constant. If delta is constant, then it is called uniform quantizer. What is delta? The step size. What is step size? Okay, before that, as I told you, So the number of levels will be equal to 2 power n. If n equal to 2, we have 4 levels. Okay, what are those 4 levels? Okay, we'll discuss now. What is delta? All those things we'll discuss. Yeah, so I'll tell you, it is an irreversible process. Okay, I'll discuss these things a little bit later. Yeah, yes. Okay, now, so actually, what is the quantization level? What is the quantization level? So first of all, suppose you take these things. Okay, this is, let us take 1, this is 2. Now the quantization level is midpoint of the quantization interval. What is the midpoint? What is the mid value of between 1 and 2? What is the middle value between 1 and 2? It is 1.5. Okay, now, so this is called interval. This is called interval. Okay, now this is a midpoint. The middle line is called quantization level. Quantization level is always the midpoint of two intervals, midpoint in the interval. So what is that? In each quantization interval, the quantization level is the midpoint of the interval. I have taken like this. Okay, so this is ik, ik plus 1. What is the middle point? Lk. Lk is nothing but this plus this by 2. Obviously, what is the midpoint between this 1 and 2? 1 plus 2 by 2, that is 3 by 2, that is 1.5. Okay, what is the significance of this quantization level? Okay, as I told you just now, here observe things very, very carefully. Okay, after sampling, you will get so many values, right? Okay, what do you get after sampling? As I told you in the last class itself, so if you sample a signal, suppose here, this is, let us take 3, 2, minus 3. This is a analog signal which is being sampled. After sampling, you get some values. Suppose this value is, let us take 1.4. This value is 1.7. Okay, 1.4, 1.7 are sample values or sampled values. Okay, now they have to be quantized. Now what I do is, okay, so what I do is here, 1.4, observe very carefully, 1.4, 1.7 are input to the quantizer because they are sampled values. Okay, now what is the output of the quantizer? Okay, here what happens is, these two values lie between 1 and 2. Do you agree or not? 1.4, 1.7 lie between 1 and 2. Which means they lie in this interval. They lie in this interval. Okay. Now they will be quantized to the nearest quantization level or rounding off. We call they will be rounded off to the nearest quantization level. So what happens here now? 1.4 lies here, but it is quantized to 1.5. If the input is 1.4 to the quantizer, output is 1.5. Next, what about 1.7? It is also lies between 1 and 2. Obviously, it lies in the same interval. If that is input to the quantizer, that is also same as 1.5. It is not 15, 1.5. Here, what is error? In this case, what is error? Q. 1.4 minus 1.5. 0 minus 0.1. In this case, what is error? What is error? Minus 0.2. Okay, that is the logic. So the basic definition of quantization is, I told you. Okay. Rounding up the sample values to the nearest quantization level is called quantization. Okay. Now, since 1 and 2 lies in this interval, they are very near to 1.5. What is 1.5? Quantization level. How we define a quantization level? It's the midpoint of the interval. Okay, obviously you lose some information. What is happening here? 1.4, but it is quantized as 1.5. 1.7, it is quantized as again 1.5. Obviously, there is a loss of error. There is a loss of information at least. Okay. Anyway, right. Yeah. So these are called boundaries. What they are called? Boundaries. Boundaries of interval. This is also one. This is one boundary. This is another boundary. Okay. Next. Okay. Yeah. Yeah. So let us take one example. Okay. So consider 2-bit encoder. Okay. First of all, they are asking to consider for 2-bit encoder, which means what is the logic? How many levels are there? L equal to 2 power. Okay. Number of quantization levels equal to 2 power n. If n equal to, it is L equal to 2 power 2. That is 4. Which means we have 4 levels. Okay, we will discuss what are those 4 levels. Okay, one by one. M of t, 2 cos 2 pi fm t, they are given everything. T equal to 4 microsecond, fm equal to 250 kilohertz, fs equal to 7.5 fm. Okay, right. What else they are given? What do you mean by this? Fs equal to 7.5 fm. What do you mean by this? It is oversampled. Why? Because fs is more than 2 fm. Okay. What x maximum? They gave us 2. X minimum, it is minus 2. Okay. Yeah. So, okay. L equal to 4. X maximum equal to 2. X minimum equal to minus 2. What about delta step size? It is x maximum minus x minimum 2 plus 2 by number of levels 4. That equal to 4 by 4. That equal to how much? 1. 1 is the step size. Okay. Next. Yeah. So this is the cos 2 cos 2 pi fm t. After sampling, this is the sample signal. Are you getting what I'm saying? You observe the things very carefully. Continuous time signal, sampled signal. So I am taking the sampled values as 1, 1.38, minus 0.2, minus 1.6, so on and so on. After sampling that signal, I got these values. Okay, you take them as example. Assume that 1, 1.38, minus 0.2, minus 1.6 are the sampled values of the particular signal. Okay, now, okay, let me write here. Yeah, okay, before that, we have to design the quantizer. How to design the quantizer? So the step size is 1, but we have to start from minus 2. Minus 2. Next, step size is 1, it is minus 1. Next, gap of 1, it is 0. Next, gap of 1, it is 1. Next, gap of 1, again 2. Now, so how many intervals are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. Minus 2 to minus 1. Minus 1 to 0. 0 to 1. 1 to 2. Okay. How many boundaries are there? Boundary lines. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 boundary lines are there. Or 5 boundaries are there. Okay. 4 intervals are there. Now, what is the step size actually? This is step size. The difference between any two consecutive boundaries is called step size. There is one more definition also, but let's assume that this is a boundary. This is a step size. You as you take this also. What is this gap? Delta 1. This is equal to 1. Delta equal to 1 here. So you take any two successive boundaries or neighboring boundaries, they have a gap of 1. That is nothing but step size. Okay. Now, so as I told you, what is the quantization level? It is a midpoint of the interval. In each and every interval, you draw the midpoint. They are called quantization levels. Here, what is the midpoint between 2 and minus 2 and minus 1? Minus 1.5. Here, in this interval, what is the midpoint of minus 1 and 0? minus 0.5. Here 0.5. Here 1.5. Now here we should have four levels. How many levels? Four levels. What are they? The levels are minus 1.5, minus 0.5, 0.5, again 1.5. These are four levels, four quantization levels, four intervals, five boundaries. Okay, not only that, now what is delta? The difference between any two successive quantization levels, it is also 1. What is the difference between minus 1.5 and minus 0.5? 1. What is the difference between these two levels? 1. Difference between these two levels also 1. So this is also delta. Delta is nothing but the difference between any two successive boundaries or any two successive quantization levels. Here you can assume, you can see here. So the difference between any two quantization levels is always, say, always 1. That is equal to delta. That is constant. That's what is called uniform quantization or uniform quantizer, because delta is kept constant. We'll discuss another type where that is called non-uniform quantizer, where delta is not a constant. Okay, we come to that later, but for time being, let us assume that delta is constant. That is called a uniform quantizer. Okay, now, so how to quantize? Suppose a sampled value is, let us take, I will assume it is, let us take minus 0.7. This is sampled value. How to quantize this value? First check in which interval it lies. In which interval it lies? Where it lies? It is between 0 and minus 1. Correct? Minus 0.7 lies in the interval of 0 and minus 1. Okay, in this interval, what is the quantization level? Minus 0.5. Which means this minus 0.7 will be quantized to the nearest level, that is minus 0.5. Okay, like that you have to quantize. Okay, now, so this is what it looks like. Okay, yeah. So in the previous example, this is minus 2 to minus 1, 0 to 1, sorry, minus 1 to 0, 0 to 1, 1 to 2. And these are levels. This is delta. And so let me call this as level 1, level 2, that is the second level, level 3, level 4. Okay. Now, so here I am directly encoding. Why encoding? Because we have taken, it is 2-bit encoder. So 2-bit encoder means you get 4 code words. 2 power 2, 4 code words. What are they? 00011011. So I am allocating 00 to first level, 01 to second level, 10 to third level, 11 to fourth level. Okay. But so don't think that minus 1.5 is encoded as 00. No. It is just an allocation. Okay. We have 4 levels, 4 code words. For each level, one code word. It is not the encoding of minus 1.5. Obviously, it is not the encoding of minus 1.5, but don't think that 00 is encoding of minus 1.5. No. It is just 4 levels, 4 code words we have. We are allocating a code word for each level. That's it. Okay. Now, so as I told you in our example, what are the actual sampled values? It is there in the problem itself. Okay. What are the sample values? Okay. 1.38. Okay. Let me write here. The sample values are 1.38 minus 0.2. What another one? Minus 0.2. And the last one is minus 1.6. I have taken few samples. There are more than these samples also. I am not taking all samples. Okay. Because the logic is same. Okay. Okay. One more thing is, so here I have defined the boundaries of intervals very carefully. Yeah, you observe this. I have defined the boundaries very, very carefully. What is the first interval? -2 to -1. -2 is included, -1 is excluded. Okay, there is a reason for this. What is second boundary is defined as? -1 is included, 0 is excluded. You know all these things, close the bracket, open the bracket. Okay, what is the third level, third interval? Obviously, 0 included, 1 excluded. Fourth level, obviously it is including both 1 and 2. There is a difference. Okay, so please make a note of this. You can follow any particular order. Okay, I will explain why we have to take open bracket, open closed bracket, open bracket. Okay, the reason is very simple, right? Okay, one, where does it lie? Where does it lie? This is one. This is one. Okay. So it belongs to which interval? Anyone? Please answer me. That one belongs to which interval? Are you there? We will answer that. Hello. So this one belongs to which interval? We have four intervals here. Who will tell the answer? Think of it. Okay. It belongs to fourth interval. In the fourth interval, what is the quantization level? 1.5. That's why it will be quantized to 1.5. 1 becomes 1.5. What is error? 0.5 or -0.5. No, doesn't matter. 1.38. It lies in the fourth interval only. It is also quantized to 1.5. -0.2. It lies in which interval? Second interval. What is the nearest level? -0.5. It is quantized to -0.5. -1.6. It lies obviously in the first interval. Obviously, it is quantized to -1.5. Okay, like this, we'll do quantization. Suppose if the sampled value is 1.5, for example, sampled value is itself is 1.5. Obviously, it lies on the boundary, it lies on the level itself. So it is quantized to 1.5 only. So in that case, there is no error. Okay, suppose if there is any value which is outside the boundary, somewhere here, suppose it is 2.5. 2.5 or 3. Let us take it is 3. It is 3 which is lies outside the quantizer limits. Then what happens? These 3 will be quantized to nearest level. What is nearest level? 1.5. Okay. If something lies outside the quantization boundary or quantization limits, that will be quantized to the nearest level itself. But this is a special case. Okay, now whenever a sample value lies exactly on the middle of the interval, so it will be quantized to the level itself, then there is no error. When it lies exactly on the boundary, you get maximum error. Okay, so to avoid any ambiguity, I have used this notation: closed open, closed open, closed open, both closed. If you don't write this closed open specifically, you will get confusion. Suppose if all are closed, if all the limits are closed, if I ask you one, this one, where does it lie? You may say it belongs to third interval or fourth interval. Then there is a confusion. Okay. Suppose if I say that there are no limits defined specifically. Suppose something like this. This is 1. This is 2. This is 3. Okay. If I say limit first interval is 1, 2, both are closed. Second is 2, 3, both are closed. If I ask you this 2, there is a sample at 2. Does it belongs to this interval or this interval? We have a problem, right? That's why what I do is closed, open, closed, open. If I say 2, it belongs to this interval because here it is closed to, here it is open to. Open bracket, close bracket. Okay. Now, yeah, this is the table. For 1, the quantized value is 1.5, error is minus 0.5. 1.38, quantized value is 1.5, error is minus 0.12. So and so. Okay, one more thing I forgot to tell you. Here is, so you can here immediately do the encoding. Suppose it is 1.5. What encoding for 1.5? 11. If it is 0.5, what a corresponding code word? 10. For minus 1.5, what a corresponding code word? 00. In the same way, for minus 0.5, the code word is 01. Immediately you can write the encoding. Here, what I have done here is, yeah, 1, 1.5, error is minus 0.5, the corresponding code word is 11. You do same thing for other things. Finally, the digital data is 11110100. Now this is the data, otherwise this is a digital signal. Okay, what is the analog signal? For this analog signal, this is a digital signal. It is done by basically three operations: sampling, quantizer, encoding. Okay, so if you quantize, you end up getting an error. An error that is called quantization error. Okay. Okay, this is very, very important. The minimum error is minus delta by 2. The maximum error is delta by 2. You observe here. What is the maximum error you are getting? 0.5. What is 0.5? In this case, so delta maximum is, Q equal to 0.5. The maximum is 0.5. But what is 0.5? 1 by 2. That is equal to delta by 2. Why? Because here delta equal to how much? Delta equal to 1. So the maximum error is delta by 2. The minimum error is minus delta by 2. The maximum error is delta by 2. You can observe these things already. The minimum error is minus delta by 2. This is very, very important. Or error lies between minus delta by 2 to delta by 2. Very, very important. You can take any example here. In this example, what is the minimum error? Minus 0.5. What is the maximum error? 0.5. Error could be 0 also. Okay. So here for this 3, for a sample value of 3, I did not take the error. Why? The reason is very simple. Because here this 3, it lies outside the quantizer limits. What are the quantizer limits? Minus 2 to plus 2 only. If something lies outside the limits, obviously you will get more error. We're talking about error that occurs whenever the sample lies within the quantizer limits. Okay, as I told you, this is a special case. This special case, don't consider this for error calculation. Okay, so these samples, these four samples are actual samples of the given signal. These are taken only for explanation purpose. Sample 3, sample 2 are taken for explanation purpose. Okay. Now, if you draw the input output characteristics of the quantizer, you get like this. Okay, this is a quantizer. As I told you already, quantizer input is a sampled signal, output is a quantized signal, right? To the quantizer, to take a uniform quantizer, the input is x, output is x cube. Now I will draw a graph between x versus x cube. Okay. Now before that, so let me draw a simple diagram. Okay. So what I do is, I'll write all these things in terms of delta. What is minus 2? It is minus 2 delta. Why? Because delta equal to 1. What is minus 1? Minus delta. 0 itself 0. 1 delta. 2, 2 delta. I'm writing everything in terms of delta. Please bear with me. Okay. Now, so here we have 2 delta. Sorry, minus 2 delta. This is minus delta, 0 delta, 2 delta. Now, so in between we have a quantization level. What are levels? Obviously, between 2 delta and minus delta, what is the midpoint of that? Minus 3 delta by 2. Between these two, minus delta by 2. This is delta by 2. This is obviously 3 delta by 2. You can observe very clear, right? How to write minus 1.5? It is minus 3 by 2. Delta is 1. You just write minus 3 delta by 2. Okay? Here, so these are boundaries. And these are, what are they? Quantization levels. How many are there? Minus 3 delta by 2, minus delta by 2, delta by 2, 3 delta by 2. Here I want to make things generalize. Okay. Here also I have done same thing. You can proceed like this. It could be, you know, it is only for how many levels? 4 levels. Okay. So if anything lies between minus 2 delta to minus delta, it will be quantized to what? Minus 3 delta by 2. If anything lies between minus delta to 0, it is quantized to minus delta by 2. Same thing for this case. Same thing for this case. Okay. So let us write this. Okay. Okay. Anyway, so this is 0. If anything lies between 0 and 1, it is quantized to 0.5. Input is x, output is x cube. If anything lies between 0 and 1, it is quantized to what? 0.5. At 0, 0 and 1 quantized to 0.5. Okay, next. If anything lies between 1 and 2, if anything lies between 1 and 2, it is quantized to 1.5. In the same way, so if anything lies between 0 and minus 1, it is quantized to which value? Minus 0.5. So if anything lies between minus 1 and 2, it is quantized to minus 1.5. So this is the input-output characteristics of a uniform quantizer. It is just like a staircase. It is symmetric. Okay. What is the delta? Okay, this is level 1, level 2, level 3, level 4. What is level 1? Minus 1.5. Level 2, minus 0.5. Level 3, 0.5. Level 4, 1.5. What is the difference between any two levels? It's called step size. Here, the step size is maintained constant. Here, the gap is same as this gap. It's same as this gap. Sorry. take this gap. Same as this gap. Okay. So the step size is maintained constant throughout the dynamic range of the quantizer. So that's what it's called uniform quantizer. Here, what is step size? This example equal to 1. Here you can replace with minus 2 with minus 2 delta, minus 1 with minus delta, 1 with delta, this is 2 delta, obviously this is 3 delta by 2, this is delta by 2, this is minus delta by 2, this is minus 3 delta by 2. You can do this. Okay. Now we are getting a staircase like structure. But here you have to observe one thing. This is called rising part. Obviously, it is riding part, no, rising part, or simply also called rise. Okay. In this staircase structure, this portion which is flat is called tread. Please remember this. In the staircase structure, the structure which is vertical in nature is called rising or rise. The structure which is flat is called a tread. Okay, so this is for, you can observe how many levels are there here. So how many levels are there? In this example, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 levels means how many encoding bits? 3 encoding bits. So these are 8 levels. This is extension of previous example. In the previous example, there were 4 levels because n was 2 there. If I take n equal to 3, get 8 levels. What are those levels? Okay, obviously, it is minus 3 delta 2 plus 3 delta. Okay, same thing. Here, okay. Here, how many levels are there? 8 levels. What are they? Minus 7 delta by 2, minus 5 delta by 2, minus 3 delta by 2, minus delta by 2, so on, so on in this way. It is symmetric about 0. Okay. So you can write for, if I say n equal to 4, what do you do? What will you do? 4 means, n equal to 4 means, total there are 16 levels. How to write them? What are those 16 levels? Okay. So you draw the structure like this. Okay. You keep on increasing like this. 16 levels. Same thing for this side. I don't count these things. You just draw like this. This side 8 levels. This side 8 levels. So just draw like this. So this is the input output curve of a uniform quantizer. Okay, one more thing is, it is called mid-rise uniform quantizer. The name itself indicates mid-rise. Why it's called mid-rise? As I told you, for this staircase like structure, we have a rising part, we have a tread. Okay, in the mid-rise uniform quantizer, origin lies in the middle of the rising part. Where does origin lie? This origin. It lies in the middle of the rising part. That's why it's called mid-rise. It's called mid-rise. Here, the origin lies in the middle of the rising part. So it's called mid-rise uniform quantizer. Why uniform? Because it is having a constant step size. The step size is kept same, constant. But the origin lies in the middle of the rising part. So that's what it's called mid-rise uniform quantizer. It is also mid-rise uniform quantizer. It is also mid-rise uniform quantizer. Okay, so there is another type of quantizer. It is also uniform, but it's called mid-tread. Obviously, What you can say? The origin lies in the middle of the thread here. Okay. Now, so they are little bit different. What happens is this is a mid thread uniform quantizer. Mid thread. It is still uniform quantizer, but the origin lies in the middle of the thread part. That's what's called mid thread uniform quantizer. How many levels are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And usually in this mid thread there are odd number of levels. There would be odd number of quantization levels. Okay, so you try to write the differences between mid-rise and mid-thread uniform quantizer. Yeah, so this is a mid-rise. You clearly observe things. The origin lies in the middle of the rising part. Here, the origin lies in the middle of the thread part. So mid-thread, mid-rise. In this, the number of levels are even, obviously even, no? L equal 2 power n. Obviously 2 power n is always even number. So it is even number of levels. Here we have an odd number of levels. Okay. Yeah, what else? So you go through this PPT, you'll find out more about this type of uniform quantizers. Okay. Right. So any doubts you can ask me. So if you don't have any doubts, we'll stop here. Okay, thank you.